Hello students, I'm here with another video from the chapter of class 10th NCERT book, that is How Do Organisms Reproduce. Before starting today's video, I would like to tell you all that till now what all things we have discussed in this chapter. So we discussed about the term reproduction, which means that the organisms are going to increase their number. Now, whenever we talk about the increase in the number, it takes place because of the presence of the DNA which is there inside the nucleus of the cell. So in each and every organism, this DNA is getting copied and it is going into the next generation. Okay, so while copying, one of the DNA, one of the strands of DNA or one part of the DNA remains same, whereas the other part is going to be changed in a very small proportion. Okay, now this change is going to be present in the next generation, or we could say that this is transferred in the next generation. Okay, so this is known as, that is why the other generation would be born with a new variation which leads to evolution. And this variation which is being accumulated in the cells is not a part of, or it is just not taking place in the one day. Okay, it takes number of years. So while whenever the variations are there, these are going to accumulate, and then what happens, this is going to be transmitted into the next generation. Fine. Now, when we talk about the variations, we need to understand that while copying, this this happens. And if the reproduction is of, means there are two types of reproduction. One is the sexual reproduction, another one is the asexual mode of reproduction. And whenever the organism is taking, whenever the organism is taking up this asexual mode of reproduction, then this variation which is being accumulated is going to be in a very small proportion. Okay, whereas whenever the sexual reproduction takes place, there the organism is going to accumulate a larger number of variations. Okay, this is because the multicellular organisms or the higher organisms always undergo sexual mode of reproduction, whereas the smaller organisms, like we discussed one of the mode of asexual reproduction yesterday, that was this fission, and in which the organism like amoeba is going to divide into two parts, and that is why this type of fission, this type of division is known as a binary fission. Okay, so we have discussed this portion which is drawn here at the board. So this is the diagram, or we have discussed about the different modes of reproduction, that is the asexual mode of reproduction, in which we have to study about various methods like fission, budding, then spore formation, then we have to study about regeneration, fragmentation, and lastly we'll study about a vegetative propagation. Okay, so from that we discussed this first part, that was fission. So here, what is the meaning of the word fission? We have already been discussing this. So fission means it is the division, or that division could be two or more in number, means one cell is there which is going to divide into two or more in number. If the division is taking place, if the cell is going to divide into two parts, or whenever one cell is there, it is going to divide into two daughter cells, it is said to be as binary fission, as this number binary means two. Okay, so this binary means two. And what is this? This is the parent amoeba which is present over here. This parent amoeba is going to grow bigger, then the nuclear division is going to take place first. Nuclear division is going to take place first, followed by cytoplasmic division. Okay, this is followed by cytoplasmic division. Now, this binary fission, in this, why this nuclear division is taking place? Because it has to transmit its DNA. Okay, so what it does, it is going to increase in the size, this nucleus is going to increase in the size. Then what it is, then this nucleus is getting enlarged, and one constriction is being present in the center, and from that constriction it is going to divide. Half of the nucleus gets shifted towards one of the part, and next half is shifted towards next part. Okay, now what happens, because of the enlargement, the cytoplasm also starts dividing. Once the cytoplasm starts dividing, it is broken down into two pieces. It is being divided into two pieces. And these two independent amoebas are now termed to be as daughter amoebas. And I have given you the reason why it is said to be as the daughter amoeba's children. Okay, so it is said because of the fact that only the female has a potential to give rise to a new individual. Fine, that is why this is said to be as daughter amoebas or the daughter cells. Okay, so that is very much clear. Now we'll discuss about the next part, type of fission, that is, okay, so in binary fission this amoeba was the first example. There could be many more examples like planaria, okay, Leishmania is also there, okay, so many are there which is going to take part in the fission, but in this only two new cells are being formed. Fine, now we are going to discuss the different next type of fission, that is the multiple fission. Okay, so this is known as the multiple fission. Now, what is the meaning of the word multiple fission? As a fission, the word fission means to divide. Now, how it is being divided? In how many cells? It is going to divide in many cells or the large number of cells. Okay, so it is said to be as when one parent cell is getting divided into the large number of cells, this is said to be as the multiple fission. Okay, now the cell which is dividing here, only two new words are there. One is the parent cell and the next is the daughter cell. Okay, so the parent cells are those where this binary fission will start, which is going to participate in asexual mode of reproduction or in this fission. Okay, now whatever is being obtained after fission, okay, this give rise to the daughter cells. Okay, so I think this might be very clear now. So we have learned two words. One is parent cell. Okay, this divides or it undergoes fission and gives rise to daughter cell. Fine. In the case of amoeba, one amoeba which was participating in the binary fission, this gave rise to the daughter amoebas. Okay, so this is known as the way this what has happened, two new cells were formed. But what about multiple fission? Multiple means more than two. Okay, it means more than two. Now, whenever more than two cells are formed, it is said to be as multiple fission. Whenever one cell is going to divide and it forms more than two cells, it is said to be as multiple fission. Now, this I am going to teach you in by taking one example which is there in your book. This is the example of yeast cells. Okay, it is the example of yeast cells. So now what happens when after this multicellular organisms multiple fission, then what happens? Small different number of cells which is more than two in number, they are going to form, and then each of the cell is getting independent, they get an independent life and they are going to grow independently. Okay, now I go on to one example. I'll take up an example for this multiple fission children. So that is given in your book, that is of Plasmodium. And I hope that you all know what you mean by Plasmodium and by where it is found. So what is this Plasmodium? Plasmodium means what is Plasmodium? Plasmodium is this is a single celled organism. I must say that this belongs to the kingdom Protista, and then this is the animal which is going to give rise to the disease called malaria. So this is the causing agent of malaria. Okay, this Plasmodium. Fine, so this Plasmodium, if you see the structure of Plasmodium, actually what happens during multiple fission, why this animals undergo multiple fission, they are not going under binary fission. So during normal conditions, the animal undergoes binary fission, okay, or it is just the way of reproduction in the animals like amoeba, plasmodium, this paramecium, then in Leishmania, okay? So all these are the animals which undergoes binary fission, where only two new daughter cells are being produced. Now, in special conditions or unfavorable conditions or the conditions which is not good for these animals, then what happens? These plasmodium-like animals, these animals are going to form one cyst-like structure. Okay, I must say that all the metabolism, all the work is going to be decreased. Okay, they are not going to undergo various life processes. They will be still. They are not going to be very active. They will be very less or least active during the cyst stage. So they reach in the cyst stage. You know what is it? During the cyst formation, what happens? It is, you should say that if we are looking at it, it looks like a non-living structure, okay? But actually it is not a non-living structure. It is a living structure where all the activities are being regressed. Means it is being decreased, fine? So when it is decreased, it means that only it is living. It is not going to perform any activity, okay? Now why does this happen? This happens because the conditions are not favorable. They are not good for living. Okay, the condition is unfavorable. Okay, whenever unfavorable condition comes, when this unfavorable condition is there, during this what happens? This Plasmodium undergoes different types of reactions, or it is going to form a cyst-like structure. Okay, it is particularly happens in a unfavorable condition. So this develops a very protective covering outside it. So it develops a protective wall. Fine. And this protective wall is going to help. This is going to protect the animal from getting, this protection is from the unfavorable condition, and this is not going to affect, this is going to protect this animal from getting damaged or from the death condition, okay? So the actual structure is present inside, which is having the cytoplasm and a nucleus, okay? So this has a cytoplasm and it has nucleus, okay? In normal condition, this has only cytoplasm and nucleus, okay? But in unfavorable condition, it develops a covering over this cytoplasm and the nucleus, because of which what happens, this is going to be protected from the unfavorable conditions, okay? Harsh conditions, whether the temperature is very high or it is very low. So during very high or very low temperature, this plasmodium could not survive, or as it is a very single celled animal, then what happens, it is not going to be having so much advanced characteristics. So what would happen? It is going to die in unfavorable conditions. To escape from the death, to escape from such harsh condition, this develops a protective cover over it. So this protective wall is going to protect this plasmodium from getting damaged. Okay, so this is a single-celled animal. Now what happens? It forms a cyst. Inside the cyst, the nucleus of the cell splits or divides several times from many smaller nuclei, and then in the form of many smaller nuclei. Little bits of cytoplasm is collected in each of the daughter cells, and a thin membrane is formed around it. Now in this way, what happens? New daughter cells are formed from a single parent cell within the cyst only. So in fact, many daughter cells are formed as the number of the daughter cells produced by the division of the parent nucleus. When the favorable condition arises, the cyst breaks open. The cyst breaks open, okay? This bursts, and then after bursting, what happens? This is going to form, each and every daughter cell is going to move in the different directions, or if it is present inside the mosquito, it could be present, it is present on the different surfaces, and once the animal is sitting over that mosquito, sits over that particular part, and then this plasmodium enters in the body of the mosquito, and then when mosquito bites us, this plasmodium enters in our blood, and then it is going to divide, and then it is going to go into the next stage, and that becomes disease for the human beings, okay, or the animals, fine. And then what happens is causes malaria as a result, fine. After that, what happens, once the cyst breaks open, many of the daughter cells present inside it is released, each forming a new organism. In this way, the single cell parent undergoes multiple fission to reproduce many daughter cells at the same time. So plasmodium is a protozoa, which is a microscopic single celled animal, which is going to reproduce by asexual mode of multiple fission. Okay, about 1,000 daughter cells are produced by one multiple fission. Okay. By one plasmodium cell. Plasmodium is the malarial parasite which produces malaria disease in human beings. Malaria parasite or this plasmodium is carried by a female Anopheles mosquito from one person to another. Therefore, it is going to spread a malaria disease. Okay. Before next is we'll move on to the next topic now. I'll just show you with the help of the diagram here. So what is the diagram for this? As I have told you, what is this? This is the plasmodium, structure of plasmodium, but in the form of cyst. Normal structure is this only. Okay, so what happens, this is going to how it is going to be multiple, it is how it is going to show the multiple fission, I'll just let you know. So what happens during this multiple fission, suppose that this is plasmodium, this is the cyst wall, then the cell is there and the nucleus is there. So this is the structure of plasmodium. Fine. Now what happens? After some time, this nucleus is going to divide and re-divide. So inside the cyst, from this one nucleus and one cell, this is going to divide. And small cytoplasm is accumulated inside each of these small plasmodium cells which are present here. So numerous of small plasmodiums are being accumulated. They are dividing and redividing, and it forms a new structure. And because of which, what happens? This is going to form a new complete now numerous of plasmodiums inside. Now these are the small cells. These small cells are known as the daughter cells. These are the daughter plasmodium. Okay, so this is the plasmodium. Plasmodium is a scientific name. Fine. So here what happens, this is going to give rise to different daughter cells. After that, what happens? Once the unfavorable condition is over, means favorable condition comes, then this cyst wall breaks up. As soon as the cyst wall is bursting, this all the multiple fission which is being formed here. So this shows this stage is said to be, this grows because of multiple fission. Now why multiple fission? As the answer is very clear to you, one nucleus is dividing several times to form many daughter nucleus. Okay. So once this daughter plasmodium is going to form, this cyst wall is going to break up. Once this cyst wall opens up, bursts up, then what happens? All the daughter cells are released. Now, when the nuclear division is taking place, I always said that whenever the cell divides, it is going to divide by the two stages. First one is the nuclear division and followed by cytoplasmic division. First the nucleus divides, then the cytoplasm divides. Now here the nucleus is present, it is going to divide and redivide, and then small cytoplasm is also accumulated in each of the daughter cells. Okay, so this is the daughter cell or daughter plasmodium, we could say, and this one is the parent cell from where the division is going to take place. So in this division is going to take place, this is the parent cell. This gives rise to multiple fission structure, and this structure is and this is known as the daughter cell. Okay. So this daughter plasmodium is going to help, it is going to grow, and how it is going to grow? Once this cyst wall is opened, this bursts up, then what happens? All the daughter cells are released outside. Okay, fine. So this cyst wall breaks up and each of the plasmodium is going to release outside, and once it is released outside, this grows in an independent plasmodium. Now this is ready as the malarial parasite. Okay, so this is the this belongs to the family of, this belongs to the phylum Protozoa. Okay, and then plasmodium, this daughter plasmodium is going to be released, and this protozoa is will be present in the different places. And once the female Anopheles is going to have this, I mean this actual in this condition, this multiple fission takes place inside the female Anopheles. Okay, now whenever this is being carried by the female Anopheles, it is, I mean this is a variety of mosquito. When this mosquito bites us, this plasmodium enters the blood of the human beings or the animals, and this again multiplies and forms a big structure, and that gives a result of malaria disease. Fine, because of which what happens, the malaria is being formed. Now we get diseased because of this plasmodium species. There are many other species. So this is how the plasmodium is doing the multiplication, and then it is going to increase in the number by the process of multiple fission. So this is the diagram for multiple fission. Now I think this might be very clear to you all, that how is this multiple fission taking place. Okay, so this is how this multiple fission happens in the plasmodium, where the cyst is going to develop, and once the cyst wall is developed, this is cyst wall. So this cyst wall, inside the cyst wall, the cytoplasm and the nucleus is present, and then it divides and redivides again. The daughter cells are going to accumulate small amount of the cytoplasm inside them, and then what happens, this cyst wall breaks up. Once it breaks up, then all the daughter cells are being released in the surrounding, and each of the daughter cell is ready to grow now. And then what happens after growing, it can cause some malaria disease. Okay, now this was all about the multiple fission. So we saw that what is the difference between binary fission and multiple fission. Now if you have to write down the differences between binary fission and multiple fission, which topics or which differences you are going to take up. So the first point says that when the division results in formation of two daughter cells, okay, but here more than two daughter cells are formed. Fine. Next, in this takes normally in the favorable condition. It takes place in the favorable condition, and this takes place in unfavorable condition. For example, this takes place in amoeba. Okay, and this takes place in where? In plasmodium. So you can draw the diagram for comparison. Okay, so as it is not clear, I'll just tilt this for some time so it will be clear. So it's written over this. So I'll just discuss this quickly. Now, the first difference is what is the difference between binary and multiple fission? As the name suggests, fission means division. And what about division? Division, when the division results in the two daughter nucleus, in the two daughter cells. Daughter nucleus means it is equivalent to the cell. Okay, So it results in two daughter cells. After that, whenever the division takes place, which results in more than two daughter cells, it is known as multiple fission. Very easy, because this binary means two in number. As we have studied the name binary in the computer language, where we say that it is 0 and 1, and it is the way by which computer works. It only understands the binary language, okay? So this is just the basic concept, and binary means bi means 2. This is very much, this is very common thing which you could understand. Bi means 2. Okay, so this 2 in number means when the division takes place, and fission means division. So whenever the cells, parent cell is dividing, it gives rise to the two daughter cells, and this is known as binary fission. Similarly, this multiple fission is different. This multiple fission is different from this binary is that a more than two daughter cells are formed. Okay, so more than two daughter cells are formed, as we have seen in this plasmodium just now. Fine, sometimes in some species of different unicellular organisms, like different protozoas are there which could undergo this multiple fission. Okay, then after that, this takes place normally in the favorable conditions in the single celled organism. Here also this takes place in the single celled organism, that is why I have not written this difference. So this takes place in the unfavorable condition, when it results in the formation of the cyst, and then cyst is going to divide, and then it is going to redivide. Fine. So this is how this plasmodium is going to give rise to the daughter cells, and each and every daughter cell is now becoming independent, and this is ready to survive in the condition which is favorable. Once the favorable condition comes, then only that cyst wall breaks. Please remember, okay? Now the next process of asexual mode of reproduction we'll discuss is budding. Okay, now I'll just come up with the next topic. The next topic is budding. The next mode of reproduction is budding. Now what do you mean by budding? Okay, so budding means a new outgrowth is developed. So bud means what? Bud is present, it is unopened flower. Okay, we could say that this is unopened flower. Now once this, where is this bud formed? It is formed in the plants. We could see when the plants are present around us, and that we can see that buds are formed. Okay, now what happens? This bud is going to give rise to, this is going to give rise to different, in the different forms. So here in this process also, a normal outgrowth from the parent cell happens. One outgrowth is coming out from the parent cell. Okay, so an outgrowth like structure. Outgrowth develops, okay, and this after developing, what happens? This is going to, so this outgrowth develops, and then what happens? This is going to detach. After some time, it detaches. Okay, it detaches from parent cell, okay, or parent organism. So once this outgrowth is developed, this breaks off, and this is going to grow in an individual, and that is said to be as budding. Now again, single budding and multiple budding both takes place. Okay, so here what happens? One outgrowth is developed. This is the outgrowth, and this outgrowth is known as bud, and this is known as the parent cell. This is known as parent cell. Now this parent cell is going to grow. Once this is fully grown, this gives rise to a small outgrowth like structure from its body, and this outgrowth like structure is going to have the nucleus as well as the cytoplasm. And once this outgrowth develops, and this is going to break, and it is going to be detached from the parent's body, and then this grows independently. Okay, so the example where budding takes place is the yeast cells. So So this is the yeast cell where the budding is taking place. Okay, so this is the yeast. This yeast is there. Okay, so yeast is the common name. I should not underline this. So yeast means this is the fungi where this budding takes place. Okay, so I'll discuss more about this budding part or this mode of asexual mode of reproduction, that is budding, in the next class in the more details. Okay, children. So in this class we have studied about the both the forms of fission, binary as well as the multiple fission. Children, binary fission means one organism breaks into two parts, and multiple fission, one organism breaks up into several other new or daughter cells. Okay, for example, this takes place in plasmodium, whereas binary fission takes place in different unicellular organism, where amoeba was one of the example which we discussed. Okay, so this was all about today's video, children. I will meet you all in the next video with the next topic, which would be the same, and we will discuss this in details in the next class. That's all for today. I'll meet you all in the next video.